To get started with your rolled paper flower, first you need to insert a rolled paper flower image. You can do this through an external SVG or using Cricut Design Space if you're an Access member. Then you need to resize your image so that it fits on your piece of felt. I am using an 8 by 8 inch piece of felt, so I am doing 2 4-inch flowers. Then on this mat, I'm arranging the flowers so that they can both cut on the piece of felt that I have. Next, you need to pick your material setting. So under all materials, I chose just the regular felt setting. And then you'll see that I chose the rotary blade for this. I have not gotten the fine point blade to work, so I always choose the rotary blade. Next, you need to insert your rotary blade. So start by removing your fine point blade. And then when you get your rotary blade, make sure the open gears are facing the machine and the plastic covered gears are facing you. Then lock it into slot B. Next, you need to prepare your mat. So start by putting a piece of transfer tape with the non-sticky side down on the mat in the top left corner where you're going to put your felt. This will keep your mat from getting covered and the little fuzzies left behind over from the felt, and it will help hold your felt in place while you're cutting it. Then remove the backing so that the sticky side is facing up on the transfer tape. Then you want to line up your felt in that upper left-hand corner over top your transfer tape. And then make sure that it's secured down and sticking to the transfer tape so that it will cut and stay in place. Load your mat into the machine and then press the go button. Then let your rotary blade cut out all your flowers. The center of your flower is going to be the bottom, and the outside is where you're going to start. Make sure your glue gun is heating up so that you can use it to close the flower. So you basically just want to start curling the flower in as tightly as you can. Then once you get it going, you want to put it between your thumb and your first finger and just continue to roll it all the way until you hit the center. After you're finished rolling, set the bottom side up on the table and get all the layers even. Then cover most of the bottom of the flower with hot glue. Then you can push that little bottom piece down in the hot glue while it's still hot using your glue gun. Then you just want to let the glue set and the heat leave before you touch the bottom again. Be careful, it's very hot. If you want to make your flower more dimensional, you can kind of pull the layers apart and create some separation, but otherwise your flowers are done.